Good morning, Calvary. Great to have you here this morning. My name is Robert Smith. Glad to have you tune in for today's word for the day. You know, as we've continued through the book of Proverbs, I've loved the intentional and practical wisdom that Proverbs shares for our life. If ever you're tempted to think that the Bible doesn't apply to you and is irrelevant for your situation in your life, look no further than the book of Proverbs, because it's intentionally practical and relevant for our life. And today we're going to see in our passage of Proverbs some very specific and practical wisdom related to our finances. And I know for some, hearing the Bible talk about finances can maybe push you off a little bit, but really it's wanting to just help us be better, help us avoid the traps, avoid the pitfalls that can happen with finances in our life. So I want to read Proverbs chapter 6, verses 1 through 5, and it says this. He says, "My child, if you put up security for a friend's debt or agreed to guarantee the debt of a stranger. If you've trapped yourself by your agreement and are caught by what you said, follow my advice and save yourself, for you have placed yourself at your friend's mercy. Now swallow your pride, go and beg to have your name erased. Don't put it off, do it now. Don't rest until you do. Save yourself like a gazelle escaping from a hunter, like a bird fleeing from a net." See, right off the bat, we're given some incredibly practical wisdom about co-signing and the danger and consequences that can happen there. And if you've ever done this, you can know that it can go badly really easily. And most of the time, you get into a situation of co-signing because you want to help and you want to be a benefit to people. But did you notice the language that Proverbs uses there? He says, if you're caught, if you're ensnared, if you're trapped after you've done this. See, the reality is that so often when those situations go bad, it is a trap, it's a snare, it's something you have to escape from. And so he gives us just the warning against that. But I want to zoom out a little bit more, away from just the co-signing application of this wisdom, and zoom back to his statements there on intensity. Because he talks on, don't rest until you've done this. Run, make it happen, do it now. He says, run like a gazelle escaping from a hunter. And if you've ever done any of Dave Ramsey's Financial Peace University or listened to him, you've heard this verse. You've heard him talking about that gazelle intensity. But really what the author of Proverbs is sharing with us here is that we need intentionality and intensity to fix financial problems in our life. Because if we're in a position where we're not happy with how things are going or the place we're at, the only way we fix it is by leaning in with intensity and intentionality. And he uses that example of a gazelle because the gazelle is committed to getting away from its hunter to survive with its life. And the reality is that if you're in a place financially that you're not in love with, if things are a mess, if you're in debt or you're struggling to pay your bills, the reality is you can accidentally get into a place like that, but you can't accidentally get out of a place like that. It takes a plan, it takes intentionality, and it takes that intensity of being willing to be uncomfortable for a season to get to the result we want. And that's all straight from Scripture saying, hey, this is wisdom for your life and wisdom for how to handle situations. And so if that's you, if you're in a place where you're in a difficult place financially, let me encourage you to make a plan, to make a budget, to set forth where you want to be and how you're going to get there. And if you need some help, plug into some of Dave Ramsey's material. It's incredibly practical and helpful Bible-based teaching on how to manage your finances. And it's going to help you find that gazelle intensity to escape from this place that you shouldn't be to get to where God has called you to go. So today, lean into the intentionality of Scripture. Lean into the intensity because God desires better than average for you. Hope this is an encouragement for you. We'll see you next time, Calvary.